Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. now back in the country following his trip to Cambodia for the 40th and 41st Association of Southeast Asian Nations Summits. Marcos, along with several cabinet members and other delegates, landed in Pasay City at past midnight. Marcos described his participation in the summits as very successful, saying he was able to articulate the country's interests and commitment to working with ASEAN and dialogue partners.
We also got the opportunity to put forward our position, our plans, and to find ways where we can help each other, where we can coordinate, and all that. I think it was quite gratifying to see that there was a very large area of consensus amongst the ASEAN member states. Ganun pare-pareho kasi sa atin yung food supply, presyo ng fertilizer, presyo ng langis, yun ang inaalalas.
However, Marcos reported that no progress was made on the conclusion of the Code of Conduct on the South China Sea. Marcos was among the ASEAN leaders who had pressed on the matter during his interventions in the ASEAN-China Summit and ASEAN East Asia Summits.
It is urgent. It is becoming more and more urgent. And we really should, the negotiations and the finalization of the Code of Conduct. There's been some progress in the past year, but we really need to have the actual Code of Conduct already finalized and already in place as soon as possible. Everybody, including the Chinese, says we follow UNCLOS and the international law. So at least that position of ASEAN is clear.
The Philippines and many other nations have repeatedly called on China to adhere to the 2002 Declaration on the Conduct of Parties in the South China Sea, which states that they exercise self-restraint in the conduct of activities that would complicate or escalate disputes and affect the stability in the region.
President Marcos urges his American counterpart, Joe Biden, to use his influence to help bring down global food prices. The two leaders met on the sidelines of the ASEAN summit. Marcos believes lower fuel prices.
We appeal as well to the United States to use its global influence to help ease the current global plight of rising fuel prices that we all have to deal with. We also encourage the U.S.'s long-term support for the implementation of the ASEAN Plan of Action on Energy Cooperation.
President Biden has expressed openness to talk more about the issue.
We just talking to the Secretary of State, and I have asked our ambassador to work on the details of what we had discussed in New York.
I think we're okay.
We can discuss that in detail.
I'd like to do that.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oil prices in the Philippines have been steadily rising in the past few months, contributing to high inflation.
Motorists will see another drop in diesel prices this week. Estimates show diesel prices may be slashed by up to 50 centavos per liter. It's not all good news, though, as gasoline and kerosene prices are expected to go up again by about 1 peso per liter. As global pump prices remain volatile, Senator Gachalian says the Philippines can turn to Indonesian coal instead of negotiating with Russia for oil.
We owe Indonesia a lot in terms of energy security, and it's a resource that is very important to us. As far as my knowledge is concerned, the Philippines has no plans of buying Russian oil. And as far as my knowledge is concerned, there is no standing offer from Russia to that effect.
President Marcos earlier said he may consider buying oil and fertilizers from Russia to pull down the rising prices of gasoline, but he was later on cautioned by experts who noted Manila may earn the ire of global powers should it transact with Moscow.